Hi, and welcome to QuickFix. This video demonstrates how to use LDAP filters and common examples when setting up QuickSense User Directory Connector. QuickSense uses the UDC to synchronize and retrieve new user entries from the supported user directory service or database of choice. When creating a UDC, the default behavior is to only synchronize data for existing users. Users are added to the QuickSense database dynamically as they use their credentials or are authenticated via SSO when accessing the hub or QMC. It is possible, however, to disable the setting Sync User Data for Existing Users, which will result in all available users being retrieved and added to the QuickSense database. In this scenario, when connecting to a directory service, it is recommended that an LDAP filter is put in place in order to help retrieving only the relevant users. The RFC for string representation of LDAP search filters can be reviewed under this location. Search string syntax information and examples can be found in TechNet on the article LDAP syntax filters shown here. As an example, we will use the following string to retrieve all users under the Active Directory security group, QuickSense users. This string searches for members of the specific group, which has a distinguished name value as stated here. This value can be found by enabling advanced features in Active Directory Users and Computers console. Then, under Groups Property, under Attribute Editor, find the distinguished name value. After synchronizing the UDC, we can see the remaining users are imported. Another common filter for retrieving all users within all nested groups is shown here. This string contains a matching rule defined by LDAP that acts as an extended match operator, which allows for recursive searches. See more information under the following Microsoft documentation website. In this example, we see that Group 0 is a member of QuickSense Users Group, and the members of Group 0 were now imported due to the recursive search. Keep in mind that the LDAP filter string can be tested directly using the AD Users and Computers console. To do so, right-click the domain name, then select Find. Specify this as a custom search, and select the Advanced tab. Here, the search strings can be tested before applying them to the QuickSense UDC. If you would like more information, search for answers using the Unified Search tool on the Support Portal. It searches across the Support Knowledge Base, Click Community, Click Help Site, and Click YouTube channels. Take advantage of the expertise of peers, product experts, and technical support engineers by asking a question in Click Product Forums on Click Community. And don't forget to subscribe to the Support Update blog. Thanks for watching. Nailed it.